Invasive species are plants or animals that are both non-natives and harmful to their newly adopted ecosystems. Such species often spread rapidly and cause severe damage due to the lack of natural predators and other factors that normally keep them in check in their native environment. In California, invasive shothole borers, a type of ambrosia beetles, are threatening the state's urban and riparian forests. They are already well established in Southern California, where they have killed vast numbers of trees and are on the move spreading to other parts of the state.
The tiny beetles tunnel into trees and introduce a fungus that they farm as food for themselves and their larvae. The fungus causes a disease called fusarium dieback that disrupts the flow of water and nutrients in the tree. In essence, the tree responds to the fungal infestation by trying to seal off or compartmentalize the fungus. Over time, too much compartmentalization combined with the beetle's tunneling activity causes tree decline, branch dieback, and tree death. Unlike many invasive pests, invasive shothole borers attack a wide variety of trees, both healthy and stressed. More than 65 tree species in California are susceptible to the pest, and several common landscape trees are particularly at risk, including sycamore, cottonwood, willow, valley oak, Engelmann oak, white alder, and especially box elder. The beetles spend nearly their entire lives inside their tree hosts. That, combined with their small size, makes the beetles hard to detect and even harder to control. But a keen eye and knowledge of what to look for and how to manage infestations, once identified, can go a long ways towards neutralizing this threat. The beetle's life cycle is fairly straightforward. It starts with a mated female carrying the fusarium fungal spores in specialized pockets called mycangia at the back of its head. The beetle finds a suitable host and tunnels into the tree, creating a gallery where it lays its eggs. The fungus introduced by the beetle grows in the gallery where it serves as food for the beetle and its larvae. Once the larvae become adults, males and females mate, and the mated females exit the gallery and start the cycle all over. Male beetles are incapable of flight and generally don't leave the gallery. The mated females do fly and may establish their own galleries in new host trees or in the trees where they developed. As with other invasive pests with no natural enemies, shothole borer populations can grow explosively. With a survival rate of just 10 to 20% of females per brood, the population of beetles can go from a single beetle to tens of thousands within a few generations. Since the already mated female beetles are not looking for mates, we can't use pheromones, a method often used with other pests, to lure them into traps. Traps using cruciferol, a plant-based lure that attracts the beetles over short distances, can help to determine the presence and concentration of beetles in a local area. Methods of control that have been shown to be effective in managing invasive shothole borers include mechanical, such as branch pruning or tree removal, and chemical, a combination of insecticide and fungicide, applied through soil drenching or injection.
The first step in managing the pest is identifying beetle activity. Unless trapping is part of your management process, you're probably not going to see the beetles themselves. However, there are several signs to indicate their presence. The main sign is entry holes to the beetle galleries. These are perfectly round holes that are about the size of the tip of a medium ballpoint pen. Trees may also have dark, wet staining, sugar-like buildup, and boring dust called frass. In severe infestations, trees may also have dead branches with wilting leaves, which is a symptom called dieback. Checking trees for these signs, managing confirmed infestations, and regular monitoring are key steps in controlling this pest and preventing its further spread. Learn more at ishb.org.